Hi everyone, and welcome to this video where we'll be looking at Substance 3D Stage's fantastic new feature that allows us to render turntables. This means we can now showcase our assets with a 360 video, either by making the camera orbit the object or making the object itself spin. Before we start setting up, here's some things to note when using this feature in its current state. There may have been updates to it since this video has been created, but the basic workflow should stay the same. We can render our turntables using either the real-time or ray tracing render engine. The timeline rendered will always be from 0 to when the final animation finishes. We can animate models, groups, physical lights, and cameras. Currently, you cannot set start and end times to be different between objects. And at the moment, you can't change the axes or the pivot targets. If you're new to Stager and you want to know how to use it, you can check out these quick start videos here. So now, let's dive into how we can set this up. When we first open Stager, we can see straight away that the UI has an extra panel at the bottom. This is the timeline panel, which is pretty self-explanatory. We can scrub along the timeline to view our animations and use the buttons to play, pause, stop, like your standard media player. Keep in mind that if you have ray tracing toggled on in your viewport, your animation will play slower and less smooth. There are two main ways we can set up a turntable. Either having a static camera and we make the object spin, or by having the object still and having the camera orbit around it. We'll start with making the object spin first. When you've selected your object, we can see in the Properties panel that we now have a new tab called Animation. When we open the Animation tab, we can see there are two sections, Orbit and Spin. We're going to turn on Spin for this example. We can offset where the pivot is for the spin by changing the values in the Target Offset section. Right now, we only spin on the Y axis, and so offsetting the Y target will not do anything. We can adjust how long the spin takes with the duration value measured in seconds. If we don't want our object to do a full 360 spin, we can adjust the rotation slider so that over the same duration, our object will only spin the amount of degrees we set. This checkbox will reverse the direction of our rotation. We can also edit the interpolation of the turntable keys by picking different settings in the easing section. Linear is the most common setting, but feel free to play around with this. Next, we can look at the orbit section. I'm going to create a camera this time so that I can use it to orbit my object. With the camera selected, I can again navigate to the Animation tab in the Properties panel and switch on Orbit, which you can see is very similar to the spin section. This time, however, we have the ability to set a target to orbit around. We can do this by simply clicking the Select button and selecting our object. For this example, we want the camera to be looking at our target as it orbits, so I will make sure this box is ticked. Therefore, our object is always being viewed by the camera at all angles. The rest of the orbit section is the same as the spin section. So now we've set up our turntable, let's have a look at rendering it. As you can see, there are not many changes. We can choose whether to render in real-time or ray tracing mode, and adjust our quality settings if needed. On the right side, we can see our regular settings, but at the bottom, you can see we have an option to take a still of the first frame or the entire turntable sequence, and then we can select our frame rate underneath. When rendering, Stager will output a PNG image sequence. We can then take this into Premiere Pro and create a video file or a GIF from it. We can import image sequences by going to File Import or Ctrl-I, selecting the first frame of our sequence and making sure the image sequence box is checked before we press Import. We can then drag this into our sequence editor, make any edits if we want, and then export by going to File, Export Media, or by going to the Export tab at the top. We can then select either an MP4 or a GIF file format. I'm going to select H.264 format because this will export an MP4. And now we can see how it turns out. We hope you'll enjoy playing around with this simple yet absolutely game-changing feature inside Substance 3D Stager.